I wish I could make reaction videos, but I was born in 1956. I've heard all these songs. What could I possibly react to?
Hey, whippersnappers. Brian here to Boomer Reacts. Welcome back. If this is your first time here, thanks for checking me out. I listen to rap and hip-hop songs using lyric videos, and then I'll let you know what I thought about them. Thumbnail tells you I'm finally getting around to Takeover versus Ether. I don't know anything about this feud. I presume that there are songs that came before these two that pertain to the beef, and definitely I know there are songs after that pertain to this beef, but you guys were telling me that these were the two songs that I should focus on. I'm not going to be experiencing the same sense of anticipation and excitement about, you know, what the next beef song was going to be. I won't be experiencing that like you guys did, like, you know, oh shit, what's next? Also, I know that Nas and Jay-Z are friends now, so that might affect my reaction a little, knowing that even though they, you know, rap these songs, that, you know, that's all water under the bridge for them. That's which you guys didn't experience at the time. I'm going to read a little bio just so I have some context about this feud. It's not going to be a whole lot, because I'm sure there's just a whole lot to the story. And I'm only going to be taking the bios up until when the songs were released. I'm not going into the future because nothing in the future affected the songs I'm about to react to now. Okay, so here's the bio. It all started way back in 1996. It's like a story. It all started way back in 1996 when Nas reportedly failed to show up to a recording session for Jay-Z's track Bring It On from his debut record Reasonable Doubt. The album dropped later that year, and in the absence of Nas, producer Ski Beats sampled a Nas line from his The World Is Yours on another Reasonable Doubt song, Dead Presidents 2. Nas' second album, It Was Written, arrived a month later. Its opening track, The Message, includes the first of many perceived shots at Jay-Z. Then in 1997, Jay-Z sampled Nas' voice again on Rap Game, Crack Game, and he also dropped a line on Where I'm From, which many consider to be his first shot fired at Nas, with lyrics such as, I'm from where, pull your card, and argue all day about who's the best MCs, Biggie, Jay-Z, and Nas. I guess that's taking a shot because I guess that's what Jay-Z considers the order to be of, you know, best MCs versus Biggie, then it's Jay-Z, and then it's Nas. In March of that same year, Biggie Smalls was murdered, and Jay-Z did not hesitate in making a claim for the New York hip-hop throne on his song, The City Is Mine. Some claim that Rockefeller artist and Jay-Z protege, Memphis Bleek, was brought into the feud with his first single from his coming-of-age album, Memphis Bleek Is... which has arguable similarities to Nas's like. And the track, What You Think of That, contains lyrics that Nas responded to on Nostradamus. Memphis Bleek decided to step things up on My Right Mind, a diss song from a DJ Clue album that could not be misinterpreted. The remix of the song was popular during the summer of 2000. On a 2001 mixtape, Nas responded to Bleek with a Stillmatic freestyle, referring to several members of the Rockefeller crew, Jay-Z, Beanie Siegel, and of course, Memphis Bleek. Then Jay-Z performed a freestyle at Hot 97 Summer Jam, taking jobs at Prodigy of Mobb Deep and Nas, and people were shook. A polished version of the freestyle became the song Takeover, which appeared on his 2001 album The Blueprint. On the Kanye West-produced track, he calls Nas a has-been, saying he has one hot album every 10 years. He questions his street cred and basically comes for him at every level. To many rap fans, Nas's music career seemed dead and gone after Takeover. Aside from its role in the Jay-Z and Nas feud, Takeover was largely seen as more damaging to Prodigy and Mobb Deep's career. I didn't even know there was a Jay-Z Mobb Deep feud. Let me know how that started. Jay-Z says, quote, Takeover was like a sport. I respected dude lyrically. I feel like I'm on top of my game. I don't feel you can compare his career to my career, but that's just my opinion. It just pushes everybody to sharpen their skills. That's what rap is about. It's a competitive sport. When you on top of the game or on top of your game, everyone is frustrated. Everyone wants to be in your position. It's ambition. That's what rap is built on. What it does to me, it makes the competitive spirit come out like, yeah, let's do it. It just gives me fire, unquote. The Blueprint is Jay-Z's sixth album and was released on September 11th, 2001. Yeah, I know I've mentioned this before in a previous bio somewhere. You know, like Jay-Z's all excited for his album to come out and then, you know, his beloved city comes under attack. Crazy, crazy emotions for him, I'm sure. Okay, let's get into the song. Okay. If I don't get everything, you know, because I wasn't there. Come
on! Woo! R.O.C. Running this rap shit. Memphis Bleak, we running this rap shit. B-Mac, we running this rap shit. Freeway, we running this rap shit. Oh, it's Spark, we running this rap shit. Chris and Neat, we running this rap shit. The takeover, the break's over, nigga. God MC, me, J-Hover. Hey, little soldier, you ain't ready for war. ROC too strong for y'all. It's like bringing a knife to a gunfight, pin to a test. Chest in the line of fire with your thin ass vest. You bringing them boys to men. Them boys pull win. This is grown man B.I. Get you rolled in the triage, biatch. Your reach ain't long enough, dunny. Your peeps ain't strong enough. Fuck up, Rockefeller is the army. Better yet, the Navy. Niggas will kidnap your baby, spit at your lady. We bring knife to fist fight. Kill your drama. We kill you motherfucking ants with a sledgehammer. Don't let me do it to you, dunny, cause I overdo it. So you won't confuse it with just rap music. R.O.C., we running this rap shit. M.E.Z., we running this rap shit. The Broad Street Bully, we running this rap shit. You're zipped up in plastic, when it happens, that's it. Freeway, we running this rap shit. Owen Sparks, we running this rap shit. Chris and Neek, we running this rap shit. I don't care if you mob deep, I hold triggers to cruise. You little fuck, I got money stacks bigger than you. When I was pushing weight, back in 88, you was a ballerina. I got the pictures, I seen you. Then you drop shook one, switch your demeanor. Well, we don't believe you, you need more people. Rockefeller, students of the game, we passed the class. Cause nobody can read you dudes like we do. Don't let them gas you like Jigger his ass and won't clap you. Trust me on this one, I'll detach you. Mind from spirit, body from soul. They have to hold a mask, put your body in a hole. No, you're not on my level, get your breaks tweaked. I sold what your whole album sold in my first week. You guys don't want it with hope. Ask Nas, he don't want it with hope. No! R.O.C., we running this rap shit. Be single, we running this rap shit. M.E.Z., we running this rap shit. Get zipped up in plastic, when it happens, that's it. Oh, it's Sparks, we running this rap shit. Freeway, we running this rap shit. Chris and Neat, we running this rap shit. I know you listen on the but along with celebrity comes about 70 shots to your frame, nigga. You are use the fag model for car, can I ask go ass. went from nasty Nas to Esco's trash. Had a spark when you started, but now you're just garbage. You fell from top 10 to not mention at all. To your bodyguards, Uchi Wally's verse better than yours. Matter of fact, you had the worst flow on the whole fucking song. But I know the sun don't shine, the sun don't shine. That's why you're careers come to one end. It's only so long, fake thugs can pretend. Nigga, you ain't live it, you witnessed it from your folks' pad. You scribbled in your notepad and created your life. I showed you your first tech on tour at Large Professor. Then I heard your album about your tech on the dresser. So yeah, I sampled your voice, you was using it wrong. You made it a hot line, I made it a hot song. And you ain't get a coin, nigga, you was getting fucked in. I know who I paid, God, Searchlight Publishing. Use your... You said you been in this 10, I've been in it 5. Smart enough, Nas. 4 albums in 10 years, nigga. I could divide, that's one every, let's say 2. 2 of them shit was due. 1 was Nas, the other was Illmatic. That's a 1 hot album, every 10 year average, and that's so. Nigga, switch up your flow, your shit is garbage. But you try and kick knowledge, your niggas gon' learn to respect the king. Don't be the next get tested on that Summer Jam screen. Because you know who, yeah, you know what, but you know who. Just keep that between me and you, nigga. R-O-C, we running this rap shit. M-E-Z, we running this rap shit. The Broad Street Bully, we running this rap shit. Get zipped up in plastic when it happens, that's it. Freak, wait, we running this rap shit. Owen Sparks, we running this rap shit. Chris and Nick, we running this rap shit. A wise man told me don't argue with fools, cause people from a distance can't tell who is who. So stop with that childish shit, nigga, I'm grown. Please leave it alone, don't throw rocks at the throne. Do not bark up that tree will fall on you. I don't know why your advisors ain't forewarned you. Please, not Jay, he's not for play. I don't slack a minute. All that thug rapping and gimmicks, I will end it. All that yapping be finished. You are not deep, you made your bed, now sleep. Don't make me expose you to them folks that don't know you. Nigga, I know you well, all the stolen jewels. Twinkle toes, you breaking my heart. Can't fuck with me, go play somewhere, I'm busy. And all you other cats throwing shots at Jigga, you only get half a bar. Fuck y'all niggas.
I actually really like that a lot. You know, it's got one of those beats that seems to me would start fights in clubs. You know I love those songs. Kanye did a great job. That beat was just everywhere except for the, you know, the driving, you know, bass that was, you know, during the whole song. There were times when there was a piano in the background. There was a time when there was an electric guitar in the background. There were times when, you know, someone was yelling in the back. I didn't quite catch what they were saying, but all of that, you know, led up to, you know, a great listening experience. And Jay did a great job with the flow. He didn't get, you know, really upset, you know, because then that people would think he blew his cool. He was just, you know, very tunnel vision about what he wanted to do. And it does seem like he was, you know, coming after Prodigy and Mobb Deep more than Nas. Like I said, I don't know what that beef is about. But anyway, thumbs up for Takeover. So now I'm going to stop the camera, and then I'm going to, you know, bring up Ether, and then I'll react to that. Okay, I'm back. Now I'm going to read a little about Ether, and then we'll get to the reaction. On his album Stillmatic, which was released in December of 2001, that's only a couple of months after the Blueprint, right? You would think. I don't know anything about, you know, record production, but you would think that by September of 2001, that Stillmatic would have been signed, sealed, and delivered to the record label, and, like, you know, nothing can be added to it. You'd think. Okay, start up. On his album Stillmatic, released in December of 2001, Nas responded to Jay-Z's claims of being a has-been by reminding Jay he's been in the rap game much longer, and he also accused Jay of selling out. Nas called Jay-Z ugly, a misogynist, and alluded to an affair he had with Foxy Brown. Nas uses a lot of homophobic slurs and tells Jay that Eminem outshined him on his own song Renegade and that Jay stole his rhyming skills from Biggie. Nas also criticized him for copying KRS-One's idea on the name The Blueprint, which was quite similar to the Boogie Down Productions album Ghetto Music, The Blueprint of Hip Hop, with Nas saying the line, KRS already made an album called Blueprint. The backing track of Ether was produced by a then relatively unknown Ron Browse. Is he well known now? That's the first time I've heard that name. The beat found its way to Nas after Browse's manager, who worked at Def Jam Recordings, bumped into Nas's travel agent and pleaded with her to give the production to Nas. And you think there'd be an easier way to get a beat to Nas, right? Browse was unaware of how his production would be used until Nas invited him to the studio to play him the completed song for the first time. Browse had previously offered the production to Kiambo Hip Hop Joshua, Jay-Z's A&R manager at the time, who turned it down. Regarding the title of the song, Nas says, quote, I was told a long time ago, ghosts and spirits don't like the fumes from ether, and I just wanted to affect him with my weapon and get to his soul, unquote. Large Professor claims that an earlier version of Ether was produced by Swizz Beatz and featured even more offensive lyrics, including a line where Nas allegedly raps, Sorry, Aaliyah, I'm sorry it was you in the plane crash. It should have been Jay and Dame Dash. Ouch. Shortly after Nas released the song, the word Ether entered the hip-hop lexicon as a slang expression synonymous with ruthlessness, meaning to harshly humiliate an opponent. To ether someone means to completely dismantle them in a rap battle with no regard for petty concerns such as logic or cleverness. It's a giant shock and awe display of machismo meant to scar the victim for life and leave an unmistakable blemish on his career. They still use ether nowadays? Regarding the album, Nas says, quote, I was working on my album and I didn't want to do ether. I didn't want to even do a record talking about another rapper. But I had to, dog. I really did. Because Holmes is the type that likes to kick people when they down and boast. Basically, it was jealousy, man. When you call yourself Jehovah, there's a lot of repercussions that come with that. I agree. You're dealing with the spiritual world. When you call yourself Jehovah, that's serious business. The God MC. Like nobody inspired you, like you were the best of all of everything. So for me to get here and say that I'm the best is sickening. It's erasing all the people who paved the way to put me there. I wouldn't know what hip hop was if I wasn't a little kid listening to Marley Marl and Red Alert on the radio, period. So I gotta pay homage to them and pay homage to Biggie and Pac in my video and never say that if I'm not better than Big, I'm the closest one. That's sick, unquote. Okay, so it's not what, not everything, it's not responding to everything that was on the Takeover. It's kind of like generally doesn't like, Jay's attitude. Okay, let's give it a listen.
Jay-Z. What's up, niggas? And yo, I know you ain't talking about me, dog. You? What? Fuck Jay-Z. You been on my dick, nigga. You love my style, nigga. Fuck with your soul like ether. Will. Teach you the king, you know you. Godson across the belly. Lose. I prove you lost already.
Brace yourself for the main event. Y'all impatiently waiting. It's like an AIDS test. What's the results? Not positive. Who's the best? Pac, Nas, and Big. Ain't no best. East, west, north, south, floor style greetings. I embrace y'all with napalm. Blows up, no guts, left chest, face gone. How can I be garbage? Send me autos at your cottage. Burner at the side of your dome. Come out of my throne, I got this. Lock since 9-1, I am the truest. Name a rapper that I ain't influenced. Gave y'all chapters, but now I keep my eyes on the Judas. With the wine, soapy fame, kept my name in his music. Check it, I fuck with your soul like ether. Will. Teach you the king, you know you. Godson across the belly. Lose. I prove you lost already. Ayo, pass me the weed, put my ashes out on these niggas, man. Ayo, you faggots, y'all kneel and kiss the motherfucking ring. Fuck with your soul like ether. Will. Teach you the king, you know you. Godson across the belly. Lose. I prove you lost already. I've been fucked over, left for dead, distant, forgotten. Luck ran out. They hope that I'd be gone, stiff and rotten. Y'all just piss on me, shit on me, spit on my grave. Talk about me, laugh behind my back, but in my face, shot some well wishes. Friendly acting, envy, hiding snakes. With your hands out for my money, man, how much can I take when the streets keep calling? Heard it when I was asleep that this Gazy and Cockefeller Records wanted beef. Started cocking up my weapon, slowly loading up this ammo to explode it on a camel and his soldiers. I can handle this for Dolo and his manuscript. Just sounds stupid when KRS already made an album called Blueprint first. Biggie's your man, then you got the nerve to say that you better than Big. Dick sucking lips, won't you let the late great veteran live?
Will.
Nah. Godson across the belly, Lose. I prove you lost already. The king is back, where my crown Ill. At? Ill will, rest in peace, let's do it, niggas. Fuck with your soul like ether.
Will.
Teach you the king, you know you.
Nah.
Godson across the belly,
Lose.
I prove you lost already. Y'all niggas deal with emotions like bitches. What's sad is I love you, cause you're my brother. You traded your soul for riches. My child, I've watched you grow up to be famous. And now I smile like a proud dad watching his only son that made it. You seem to be only concerned with dissing women. Were you abused as a child, scared to smile, they called you ugly? Well, life is harsh, hug me, don't reject me. I'll make records to disrespect me, blatant or indirectly. In 88, you was getting chased to your building, calling my crib, and I ain't even give you my numbers. All I did was give you a style for you to run with, smiling in my face, glad to break bread with the guard, wearing jazz chains, no text, no cash, no cars, no jail bars, jigger, no pies, no case, just Hawaiian shirts, hanging with Little Chase. You a fan, a phony, a fake, a pussy, a stand. I still whip your ass. You 36 in a karate class. You Tai Bo Ho, trying to work it out. You trying to get brolic. Ask me if I'm trying to kick knowledge. Nah, I'm trying to kick the shit you need to learn, though. That ether, that shit that make your soul burn slow.
Burn
Is he Dame Diddy, Dame Daddy, or Dame Dummy? Oh, I get it. You Biggie and he's Puffy.
Yeah.
Rockefeller died of AIDS, that was the end of his chapter. And that's the guy I chose to name your company after? Put it together. I rock hoes, y'all rock fellas. And now y'all trying to take my spot, fellas? Philly's hot rock fellas. Put you in a dry spot, fellas. In a pine box with 9 shots for my Glock, fellas. Foxy got you hot cause you kept your face in a puss. What you think, you getting girls now cause of your looks? Negro, please, huh. You know mustache having with whiskers like a rat compared to beans you whack. And your man stabbed on and made you take the blame, you ass. Went from jazz to hanging with Kane to Irv to Big. And Eminem murdered you on your own shit. You a dick riding faggot. You love the attention. Queens niggas run you niggas. Ask Russell Simmons. Huh, R.O.C. get gunned up and clap quick. J.J. Evans get gunned up and clap quick. Your whole damn record label gunned up and clap quick. Sean Carter to Jay-Z, damn you on jazz dick. So Little Shorty's getting gunned up and clap quick. How much of Biggie's rhymes is gonna come out your fat lips? Wanted to be on every last one of my classics. You pop shit, apologize, nigga, just ask Kiss.
I know I missed stuff, you know, there's lingo in it and history. But as far as the song, I think this song was more to the point. It was written better, but the beat wasn't better. The beat in Takeover was better. This one's rhymes and the general feel of, you know, not only did you diss me on this song, but your general outlook is not good, you know, because, you know, I'm your coworker, you know, and you're saying bad things about me. Manoz was not only responding, he was saying, you know, stop acting like a dick. His rhymes and his flow were really good. It was like no nonsense. It was like, I have to say this and here it is. Whereas the beat on Takeover was more, you know, driving, fight inducing. But as far as like who won, I don't really know. You know, I wasn't there. I didn't experience it like you guys experienced it. So I can't say who won. I can only say, you know, what I liked about Takeover and what I liked about Ether. And I just told you what I liked about each one. But as far as like what's the better diss or who won between these two songs, I don't know. But Takeover had the better beat. Nas had the better message. Well, thanks for hanging with me, guys. I finally got around to this diss duo. It's been a long time coming. If you like this kind of content, give me a like and a subscribe, and I will see you on the next video. Bye.